So today's little tip is just to show you how you can put text in InDesign on a line that's not perfectly straight. It may be running on a curve or on some kind of corner. And the tool I'm going to show you for that is the pencil tool. Now, for those who are eagle-eyed and use Illustrator, you'll notice right next to it there is a pen tool as well. And if you're familiar with that, then that's absolutely fine. You can do it with that as well. For those who haven't used Illustrator before or have never heard of the pen tool, that one can take a little bit more learning. So I'm going to show you it today using the pencil tool, which I just think is a little easier to use potentially. With the pencil tool, when you click on it, if you draw on the page here, you might see at first that the line you get there is a little bit jittery and a little bit jerky. It's not a very smooth line. If that's the case, select the tool and then double click and you'll see the pencil tool preferences come up. And what you really need to worry about is the smoothness. Now, fidelity is how close it draws the line to where your mouse went. So if that number is higher, it will draw the line potentially further away from where your mouse went. Smoothness is how much smoothing it then applies afterwards. So I want a line that pretty accurately follows my mouse, so I'll keep the fidelity low, but I'm going to bring the smoothness up, and we'll take it up to maybe 60%, something like that. So it should smooth that line nicely afterwards. And if I click OK to that and just draw again, and we'll do it down the bottom, you can see I'm doing a very similar line, but what it does this time is it then applies the smoothing. So lots of those points, if you look at the first line, there's probably 50, 60 little points in there. If you look at this line, you've only got about 8, and it's smoothed the whole line out. So it's a much nicer way of creating those nice smooth curves like that. If I then want to put text on there, the tool I need to use is tucked away in with the type tool. And if you click and just hold your finger down on the mouse, you'll see there are other options in here. And the option we want is the type on the path tool. And with that tool, I can go down here. When I hover over the line, you'll see a little plus appears. Can you see that little plus appearing on the icon? And that allows me to then click there and I can actually type on here. Or if I want to, I can right click and I can fill with placeholder text and use the placeholder text. This can be formatted like any other text, so I can make it bigger, I can change the font face, I can do anything else that I can do in my normal text, make it caps, for example. So that's all options. And you've now got proper text on there. The other thing you can do when you right-click is go to the type on a path options. You can get to them here. You can also get to them in the type menu. You'll see them there as well. And what they will allow you to do is they will allow you to actually format this in terms of, do I want to flip it, for example, and have the text run around the inside or flip it back? Do I want the path to be bottom or top? And it can adjust that kind of spacing and positioning, and I can change the baseline if I want. That makes even more of an adjustment there. You'll see it jump around quite a bit, so you might do that and then flip it, for example. So there's all sorts of options in here for you, how you might want to move those around. And I'll just go back to baseline there. And you can also change different effects. And you can go for things like 3D ribbon effect or a stair step effect if you wanted to, for example. Switch it back to rainbow. So that's a nice, easy way. If you notice at the end, when you've come off it, that there's still a black line there. And if you go over into preview mode, you can still see a black line there. It's quite easily fixed. Just click on it with the black arrow rather than the type tool. And then at the top here, just set the stroke value to 0. And you'll see that that line has now disappeared. And you can just see the text sitting on there without the line underneath. So hopefully that makes something that seems quite difficult sometimes into quite an easy process for you.